Hello and welcome to the third part of our brief introduction to the UOS Data Hub. In the first two parts of this tutorial series, we have seen how the Data Hub is structured and how data transfer between different client applications via the Data Hub works. We also learned about authorized access according to Oauth 2. We remember, there are two roles that client applications can assume. Providers such as the UOS IO Configurator, with which a hardware configuration of the automation system can be created and configured, and consumers such as Node-RED for creating applications in the IoT area. I would now like to give you a practical example of how this data exchange between the Node-RED consumer and the UOS IO Configurator provider actually works. Let's imagine that we want to monitor the temperature of a room. In this room, air conditioning ensures that our employee does not break a sweat. But it could be that the air conditioning system fails. Or there is some other problem that is causing the room temperature to rise to an unbearable level. If the room temperature reaches or exceeds a limit temperature that can be set using a rotary switch, in our case 30 degrees Celsius, the facility manager or a service technician should be informed about that. For this, a red alarm light is to be illuminated in his office, and he also receives an email notifying him of the increased temperature. As soon as the temperature falls below the limit value of 30 degrees Celsius, the alarm light goes dark again and an email is sent once more with the message that the temperature is okay again. We now want to implement this with our UControl starter kit. For this we use the following elements. We will use the PT100 temperature sensor to measure the room temperature. This sensor is connected to the temperature measurement module on channel 0. We use the potentiometer connected to the analog input module on channel 0 as the rotary switch for setting the temperature limit value. And the red light of the starter kit, which is controlled by channel 0 of the digital output module, acts as the alarm light. To send emails, we connect the Ethernet port X5 to the internet. This allows us to reach the external mail server, which then forwards the email to the service technician. We will now implement this small practical example under UOS. We have already done some preparatory work on this in the first part of our tutorial series. In the UOS IO Configurator, we first configured the URemote modules connected to the UControl system bus. To do this, we used the scan button to have the system automatically detect the connected modules and then configured the channels for the analog inputs used. Firstly, the analog input with the connected potentiometer for the temperature limit value. Here we used a measurement range from 0 to 10 volts. And on channel 0 of the temperature measurement module, we specified that we have connected a PT100 with a measurement range of minus 200 to 850 degrees Celsius. Finally, this configuration was deployed. We could then see in the Data Hub that the provider UOS IO Configurator makes its variables available under the name UOS SBM. These variables can now be used by other apps via the Data Hub, in our example by Node-RED. Next, we will install Node-RED on our controller. To do this, the controller must be connected to the internet. I use the Ethernet port X5 for this and configure the network settings accordingly in the UOS Control Center under Network and Internet and then Ethernet. I go to the Network Settings via Edit. Here I select the Ethernet X5 tab and change the IP configuration to DHCP and accept the new setting with Apply. Now I connect my network cable to X5, which is also displayed after a refresh. Then I switch to the App Manager and click the Install App button. This calls up the App Hub and I can now select Node-RED from a list of apps. After accepting the software license agreement, we can now select the software version to be installed. We decide to use the latest version. Clicking on the Install button installs Node-RED on our UOS device. After installation, Node-RED is displayed as an app in the App Manager. As we can see, this app is currently starting up. By clicking on Refresh, we can update the display and there we have it, the app is now in running status and can be used. By clicking on the app tile, we now have access to Node-RED and can open the user interface with Open. When Node-RED is started for the very first time, a welcome window appears and we are invited to learn more about the latest features in this release. However, we skip this and the user interface appears. On the left-hand side of the screen, we see a list of all available nodes, divided into different categories. In the middle is our editing interface, and on the right-hand side we see the debug and info area, where we can test the flows we have created. Let's start creating our flow right away. From the node list, we drag the UOS Data Hub node from the Weidmüller category into our editing area. Double-clicking on this node opens the corresponding properties window. Here, we first create a new configuration for data transfer via the Data Hub. For authorized access, the access data for the client, that means client ID and client secret, are required here. If we have not yet done so, we now create a client under UOS. This procedure was explained in more detail in the second part of our tutorial series. We remember, in the UOS Control Center, we can create a new client under the menu item identity and access. I name the client Temp Monitoring because I want to use it for temperature monitoring. Under permissions, I select Read and Write because I want to use the client to read the analog values and write to the output for the red light via the Data Hub. I now receive an ID and the client secret for the client, which I copy from this window and paste into Node-RED in the Properties window for the Data Hub configuration. I complete the configuration with Add and return to the Property window of the Data Hub node. With this node, we first want to read the analog value from the potentiometer. The transfer direction is therefore IN, four inputs, and the provider is UOS SBM, that means the IO Configurator. Now I need the variable key for this analog input, so I switch back to UOS, complete the creation of the client and open the Data Hub. All providers and their variables are listed here. As we recall, the potentiometer is connected to channel 0 on the analog input module UR20 for AI UI16. So I look for the corresponding analog input in the variable list and the associated variable key is displayed. I now copy it and paste it into Node-RED in the Properties window. Finally, we give the node a descriptive name so that we can immediately see what this node is used for in the flow. That's it. Now I want to test this node. To trigger it, I use an inject node, which I connect to the input of the Data Hub node, and I place a debug node at the output. With deploy, I now load this flow into the controller and test it. I turn my potentiometer fully to the right and trigger the inject node. As expected, I get approximately the maximum value as a result. I turn my potentiometer back a little and trigger the inject node again. Now, as expected, I get a much lower value, so the Data Hub node is working. We would now like to use this analog value to generate a temperature limit value that ranges between 15 and 40 degrees Celsius, depending on the position of the potentiometer. So we remove the debug node and arrange for the Data Hub node to be triggered cyclically every second rather than manually. To convert the analog value into a temperature limit value, we use a function node, which allows us to write a small program in JavaScript for this purpose. First, we give this function a suitable name and start with a variable declaration so that this temperature limit value can be used for the entire flow, and assign this value to 30 degrees Celsius as a precaution. Now for the actual assignment, we multiply the input value of the node, that means the analog value of the potentiometer, by 25, divide it by the maximum value of the analog input and add 15 degrees Celsius. The result is a value between 15 and 40. We now save this temperature limit value for the entire flow. In addition, we assign this value to the output of the function node. Let's take a look at the result. We add a debug node at the end and transfer the flow to the controller. The calculated temperature limits are now displayed every second in the debug window. I now turn the potentiometer all the way to the left and we get the minimum value of 15 degrees Celsius. And when I turn the potentiometer all to the right, we get the maximum value of 40 degrees Celsius. So the flow is working and we can continue. Next, we retrieve the temperature value from the PT100 via the Data Hub. Since this node is similar to the one used to read the potentiometer value, I copy this node and simply change the variable key in the properties. As we recall, the PT100 is connected to channel 0 on the analog input module UR20 for AI RTD Diag. So we look for the corresponding analog input in the variable list and the associated variable key is displayed. We now copy it and paste it into Node-RED in the Properties window. Finally, we also adapt the name of the node, and that's it. Now we will also perform a conversion for this value using a function. The measurement module provides a temperature in tenths of a degree Celsius, so we simply divide the input value by 10 to transfer the actual temperature value as the output value. Now we just need to connect the nodes and also trigger the new data hub node via the inject node. We now connect the debug node to the new output, transfer the new flow and look at the result. For a better overview, I will first delete the old content. As we can see, the temperature measurement module gives us a value of 27.1 degrees Celsius. I will now rub my fingers on the temperature sensor on the starter kit and, as we can see, the temperature is now rising. So the transfer of the temperature value and the conversion are working. Next, we will check whether the temperature value has reached or exceeded the limit value. To do this, we write another function and give it the name temperature check. First, we retrieve the stored temperature limit value. In the next step, we compare the input value of the node, that means the temperature value, with this limit value. The output of this function node is a Boolean value that is set to true if the temperature reaches or exceeds the limit value. To monitor the result, I disconnect the debug node, move it downwards and connect my nodes to form a complete flow. After deployment, we can now see the result of the temperature check node. The temperature has not yet exceeded the limit value. I now turn the potentiometer to the left to reduce the limit value and see what happens. The output changes to true, as desired. If I now increase the limit value again by turning the potentiometer to the right, the output goes back to false, just as it should. Now let's go one step further and use this output to switch on the red light on the starter kit. So I delete the debug node and replace it with our data hub node. In the properties window, I select the configuration I already created for our client under config and this time I select out under direction because we want to control the output for the red alarm light. The variable for this is provided by our provider UOS-SBM. We remember that the red light is connected to channel 0 of the digital output module UR20-8DOP. So we look for the corresponding variable key in the variable list, copy it and insert it in Node-RED in the property window at the corresponding place. Now we give the node a suitable name and that's it. The red light is now controlled according to the true or false input from the previous temperature check node. Now for the last point of our practical example, we send an email when the temperature limit is exceeded and another one when the temperature falls below this limit again. To do this, we first attach a function node to the output of the temperature check node, which we want to call creating message, and develop a small program in JavaScript that creates the corresponding message texts depending on the true or false message at the input of this node. Finally, we enter the text for the subject line of the email as the topic of this message and close the window again. If we were to attach an email node immediately afterwards, an email would be sent every second. To prevent this, we add a filter that only allows messages that differ from the previous ones to pass through. Now we can attach an email node, but there is no corresponding node in our list. However, since Node-RED is an open system for which many developers worldwide provide nodes, we can download nodes for all kinds of tasks and functions via the internet. There is a menu for this under Manage Palette. We simply enter a search term in the Install tab, in our example, email, and a list of corresponding nodes is displayed. I choose Node-RED node email and install it. After installation, we are shown that new nodes have been added to our palette. By the way, under Nodes, we can see which node contributions are already installed. Here we see standard nodes, node contributions to the UOS Data Hub, and now new, nodes related to emails. These nodes now also appear in our palette, and we select the email node with an input, place it behind our filter node and open the properties window by double-clicking. First, we assign a suitable name to the node and then enter the email address of our recipient. In our example, I am using the address of a nice colleague who is also happy to answer any questions you may have about UOS and the Data Hub. As our mail server, we are using the GMX server in our example, where I have already created an email account for our control system at the address uosm4001@gmx.net. Now just enter the password and the node is ready. Finally, we connect the email node to the filter node and transfer the flow to the UOS device. Now let's move on to the final test. To do this, I open my colleague's email inbox and turn the potentiometer for the temperature limit on the starter kit all the way to the left. Now the red light on the starter kit lights up and an email is sent. A short time later, it appears in the mailbox with the subject line, sender, and the message, temperature is too high. I now turn the potentiometer on the starter kit all the way to the right again. The red light turns off and another email is sent with the message, temperature is okay again. Okay, so much for our practical example, in which you could see in detail how communication via the data hub between a provider such as the UOS IO Configurator and a consumer such as Node-RED works. I hope I was also able to give you a little taste of the many other possibilities that UOS with the UOS data hub opens up for you. In the next part of this tutorial series, I will go one step further and show you how to develop your own apps under UOS that can communicate with other providers via the data hub using the Variable NATS API. Stay tuned and see you then.